issued an amendment or an addition to the Societies Act, which highly affects the church or the body of Christ, which you are a part of. The amendment issued on the 31st of December is one that a majority of the Christian leaders have not seen, neither heard about it, or even been informed in any way. However, it affects from the church that has two people or one individual to the churches that are filled with thousands. It affects us all as a body of Christ. And if there's ever been a time that us as a body should be united, this is it. What I'm going to tell you today is a result of about 84 hours of study into this document, study into our constitution, and study into the word of God, which is our foundation. So I'll hand it from a discussion that we've had with legal teams, a discussion that we've had with leaders in the church, and a discussion that we've had with the oracles of God. Our Constitution of Kenya, which was instituted, and the Attorney General held a Bible in one hand and a constitution on the other, and swore to protect the words of this constitution. The words of this constitution read as so. Section 32, freedom of conscience, religion, belief, and opinion. Every person has a right to freedom of conscience, religion, thought, belief, and opinion. Every person has the right to either individually or communally with others in public or in private, to manifest any religion or belief through worship, practice, teaching, or observance, including observance of days of worship. A person may not be denied access to any institutions or any organizations based on their belief. This is a freedom in which every government official has sworn to protect to the end. This is your right, your freedom. But on the 31st of December 2015, that freedom was put at risk when the Attorney General instituted an amendment to the Societies Act by adding rules that govern the religious societies. Now, we are calling them religious societies. However, Kenya is 80% Christians. So a majority of the people who are affected by these rules are you and I. It's the body of Christ, the church. Number one that we disagree with is the fact that in the Societies Act, a definition of a society is a group or a company. So political parties, football clubs, and churches, and where people gather is considered a society. However, the attempt of the Attorney General to take the societies and separate them to one group, a religious society, is what the English language calls discrimination and sector profiling. If, according to our constitution, Kenya is a non-religious state, if that is truly the fact, then the Attorney General's office has no mandate to regulate religion. Number two, we do understand as a body of Christ that yes, everything is not okay. We have some members and ministers who preach the gospel and according to their interpretation have polluted the believers. They have polluted in offerings, they have polluted in giving and manipulating people with false miracles. That is a true fact. However, in the government of Kenya, societies like political parties have also been attacked with the same offenses. We stand at a time when preachers have been accused of 310 shillings offerings. You cannot, at any point, you cannot over-regulate and overreact because of a minority. The truth of the matter is this. There are small churches in this country which are struggling to keep their doors open. The truth of the matter is this. Since the year 2014, the Attorney General put a freeze to registration of churches. That means that the body of Christ in the churches have not grown since 2014. Other religions are open to opening their places of worship, but the church has not grown one church since 2014. That is the reality of the matter. So we cannot take a small amount and overregulate. That is one thing that as a body of Christ we should not stand for. In addition to that, the requirement of theological degrees and background and vetting of religious leaders. For me to be able to hold a mic in a congregation of more than 10 people, I have to have a theological degree. I want you to think about the pastors and men and women of God in this country who are really making an impact in our youth. And I want to appeal to the church, not just this generation, but realize that God will hold us accountable to the generation that is coming behind us. They will say we are the ones who permitted these antichrist laws to be made effective. If you keep quiet at this time, God will hold us accountable. There is a generation that we are reaching. The young men and women, the young preachers, the street preachers are reaching a generation. Who is going to tell them that they require a degree to preach the gospel? And the word that has been used is a theological degree. The other religions do not have theological degrees. It's only Christians who have these theological degrees. In addition to the requirement of theological degrees, we are to submit, according to section 5 of the rules, we are to submit teaching materials, doctrine, classes, and the things that we are teaching the people to the umbrella bodies which gives access to the registrar. So in other words, we are to submit to the government what the bishops and the men and women of God are preaching. So in Kenya, we have added an additional Holy Spirit to analyze our notes. That is the reality of the matter. In addition to that, there is a minimum requirement of membership. There is a requirement, number one, to take every member's name, ID, physical address, and our Attorney General has been very kind to give us the forms that we are supposed to give our members for you to give us your name, your ID number, your physical address,
and offerings and contribution.
The day you became a member, the day you left, a record of all financial records and givings of the church must be submitted. Membership from the society level to the umbrella bodies. I want to explain these umbrella bodies as they read. An umbrella body is a body that has 2,500 societies. A society is considered a church. So if you have more than 10 members and you're worshipping God maybe in Turukana under a tree, you're supposed to go find Bishop so-and-so and so-and-so, and 2,500 of you small churches should gather together and make a circle. Like the Matatus, you make a circle and go and join a circle that is going to be overseen by an umbrella body. And at any point in that umbrella body or the government, the new rules read this way. The umbrella body church. So the umbrella body becomes the body that is talking on your behalf to the government. So if there is a disagreement between those two parties, the umbrella body can come and shut down the churches that oversee, that they oversee. Today the church in Kenya is more divided than ever before. How many of you truly believe these umbrella bodies will be fair and equal to all the members of the churches? It's unrealistic. And I said at the beginning, yes, there are places we've failed. But this is not the approach we should take, Mr. Attorney General. This is not it. Secondly, we are a country where there is separation of the government and religion. So telling the umbrella bodies to create a place where we can all meet and sit down and discuss with the heathen is completely ungodly and unconstitutional. There is a requirement for tax clearance. Tax clearance and submissions, not just to the main churches, but also to the religious societies. In other words, if Giyama has different branches, those branches now have to be registered. I'll tell you the implications of this. The implications of this is this. Number one, if you have to register every branch, if today you went to Equity and said, I want to be an agent, Equity doesn't tell you that you have to go and register yourself. They register you themselves. You understand? So if a pastor wants to open a GM branch or a church branch, we regulate, we make sure that they are doing everything right, and we ensure that the branch is running based on Jesus is Alive Ministry. However, there is a requirement for all branches to be registered. And the person who is overseeing that branch has to have a theological degree, has to have an ID and an assessment, I don't know, review of conduct and all these things. So what we are saying today is this, that the people who get saved in prison can never be preachers in Kenya. What we are saying is this, that John the Baptist, the Paul, Jesus Christ himself can never preach in Kenya, because number one, we require them to be registered. Number two, we require them to have a theological degree. Today, as a body of Christ, we need to realize there was a time you were a sinner, and today you're saved by grace. There was a time that you may not have had a good record, but the blood of Jesus came and intervened into your life. I don't know how you can be quiet. Already the church files returns under the tax code of the society bodies. So don't give us an additional rule on filing returns. And the constitution, according to the constitution of our nation, taxes are an issue of KRA, not the Attorney General's office. Secondly, we say they are preachers who have stolen. They are also government officials who stole 700 plus million from NYS. So do exactly what you would do to a government official to the preachers in the church. Weka pingu, umpeleke kotini, and you charge him, they bring their lawyers, you bring your lawyers. Do not over-regulate. No over-regulation in the church. The attempt to over-regulate is returning us back to the days of Egypt. They are returning us back to the Old Testament. They are taking us back to rules and regulations. But according to the word of God, through the blood of Jesus Christ, we are set free from rules and regulations. Attorney General, we do recognize that your office has the mandate to come up with rules and regulations to allow you to better carry out the Society's Act. However, these rules must comply with Article 47 of the Constitution, which provides that every person has the right to administrative action that is expressly effective, lawful, and reasonable in procedural fairness. If any right or fundamental freedom of a person has been or likely to be adversely affected by administrative action, the person has the right to give written notice or the right to share their opinion, which is what we are doing today. This is how these laws have affected us. One document, as I come to an end, is the media bill. I'm going to read to you exactly what that media bill says. The statement in the media bill says this, and I quote. The statement in the media bill says this, and I quote. A broadcaster shall not be involved in proselytism. How many of you know what proselytism is? That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Because no matter how many degrees I have, when I read that word, I did not understand it. I told you for 78 hours I've pursued these documents. The definition of proselytism is the act of attempting to convert people to another religion or opinion.